Hello, and welcome to the Kentucky Governor School for the Arts application walkthrough video. Today, we'll be filling out the musical theater application. Though this is only one of nine art forms, they have similar elements to their applications. First, we'll visit www.kentuckygsa.org with Kentucky spelled out. You'll click on the hyperlink to the GSA 2023 page. When you click on this link, you'll be sent to GSA's accepted landing page. From here, you can create your account and begin the application process. Keep in mind, if you are 16 years or older, you'll be able to create an accepted account by yourself. If you're younger than 16, your legal parent or guardian will create an account for you, then add you as an applicant to start filling out the GSA application. If you're under 16, please visit the link in our description for parent account setup instructions. Now we'll begin part one of the application process. Don't forget, we also have a save button so you can start your application and save it as you go along. Part one of the application process is pretty easy. You're just entering basic contact information such as your first and preferred names, last name, mailing address, phone number, email address, school and personal email address, etc. This is setting up general information about you. One question you'll be asked is if you give GSA permission to share your contact information with colleges. This does not affect your GSA application, it is to connect you with resources if we can. Next, you will enter the information for your two recommenders. For guidance on who we suggest for recommenders, please review the applicant guide. Here, you will provide the correct email addresses for your recommenders. Please be sure that your email addresses are correct. On this new page, you will be able to review the information you've submitted. This is not the entirety of the application, just part one of two that you'll complete initially. Once you've hit submit, you will get a thank you message telling you that you've successfully submitted your application. If you are applying to two different art forms, please save your application number so you are only charged a $35 application fee and not a $30 fee twice. Once you are back to the application homepage, you will click the continue button. This will open the application part two. This is where you will upload your art form specific materials. If this is your second application to GSA, you will have to enter your application ID from before. Now, you will go through the questions. Free reduced lunch, which waives your application fee, date of birth, your gender identity, pronouns, grade, county of residence. If you go to a school in a different county, please list the county your home is found. Your race or ethnicity, your high school. Whenever you select your high school, a pop-up window will occur. It will ask you to select your school from a drop-down list. If needed, you can choose no school listed if your school is not listed. This will ask you to manually enter your high school. The next question says, how did you first hear about GSA? And if you've attended or viewed a recording of a GSA virtual info session. You will also upload a headshot. Ideally, this is an image of you that is clear or easy to see. It does not have to be a professional headshot. A selfie of you in your living room is perfectly acceptable. You'll also check the certification box at the end. Then you'll add your primary communication, including your phone number, your email, and an optional second email. Then you'll fill out information about your guardian, including their name, address, phone number, and email, and who you live with. From there, you'll click continue or save draft button. Finally, you'll have art form specific questions. Here, you will upload your essay, videos, and artistic work. Sometimes, whenever you upload your videos, it can take a while to process. That's okay. You can continue your application while the video processes. Next, you can answer your art form specific questions. These questions typically are to gauge you as an artist and to get to know you a little bit better. There are no wrong or right answers. Once you hit continue, this will take you to the review page so you can review all of your answers. Double check your videos and make sure you can hear your sound. And because this is a test application, we can't follow through with the submit button. If this were an actual application, the next window would have you enter your payment information if you qualify. And that's it. You can always go back to your applications tab to check on the progress of your application or review your submission.